How much do marine biologists get paid? This is actually a tricky question to answer because it's extremely variable, which is true of many answers when you're talking about science careers. So, as you might guess, you get paid a different amount depending on your experience. So, if you're an undergraduate, for example, working in a research lab, you often don't get paid. You're often voluntary. So, for the first several jobs I had as a scientist, helping other researchers do their science, I did it all for free. I volunteered, and what I got out of that was experience that was good for me for later job opportunities. But eventually, I did start getting paid. This was many years ago, so it probably doesn't help to tell you how much I got paid, but it was not a whole lot. Sort of close to minimum wage in the US. And once you get out of that stage and you get into graduate school, many graduate programs actually do pay you. That's often a misconception about going into sciences professionally. You often don't have to pay for graduate school. You get paid to go to graduate school, and in exchange for that money that you're being paid, you will either teach or do research, or oftentimes a combination of the two of those things. And that compensates for the money that you're being paid to live. It's basically a stipend. And that amount can be also highly variable. I can tell you from my own experiences and through friends of mine, I think it's safe to say at this point that it's around 20 to 30,000 US dollars a year for many PhD programs that I'm aware of. Master's programs, it's often much more challenging to get funding. Oftentimes, I know students will often take out loans to help pay for their master's degree. For PhDs, that's far less common. And then once you finish getting a master's degree or getting a PhD, again, the job that you get and how much that pays you can be highly variable. I can say that on the traditional academic route, so if you go through graduate school, you end up with a PhD and you want to work at a university as a professor. Starting out as a tenure track professor, you're usually going to be making over 70,000 US dollars a year, but that can be highly variable again. And over time, you can accrue more and more income as you get promotions and you get more and more experience, more and more publications, you eventually get tenure. You get paid more and more each of those rungs. So it's not at all uncommon in the United States for a scientist that's a professor at a university to get over 100,000 US dollars per year in salary. So that's a decent amount of money. You can do a lot with that each year. So I would argue, in general, if you're really worried about money and you're thinking about pursuing a career in marine biology or really any science, you should stop and think about why you think you need a lot of money, because this career offers lots of perks that many other careers that may pay a lot more don't offer. For example, by applying for grants and getting additional money to go fulfill my dreams, to go do research in French Polynesia or Mexico or Southeast Asia, I'm actually getting a lot more sort of income. Although it's not actually income for me, it's paying for the research, it's paying for the travel and all the equipment and all of the nuts and bolts that go into actually making that research a reality. I don't count that as income, and scientists generally don't count that as income. It's not part of their living. They're not paying for their housing and their food for that, generally speaking. So there's a lot more to this career than just what is your salary. I guess maybe a more appropriate question is how free are you to do what you want to do? And I think many scientists that have successful research careers are very free to get more money and do what it is they want to do. So it's a little challenging to dissect this too much from a strictly salary perspective, which you might often do for other career tracks, like going into medicine or law or something like that. Science is a little bit different.